Let's look at epoxidation of alkenes with a peroxyacid such as mcpba. A couple things we know about this reaction. It is a same side addition. Both carbons will be connected to the epoxide on the same side of the double bond, top or bottom. From our view, we're looking at it from the top. We also know that the mechanism is concerted and it's one step. Okay, and so everything happens at once in concert. So let's predict the products first based on what we know. Syn addition says if we add to the top with our epoxide, it's going to push the methyl down. And if we add from the bottom, it's going to push the methyl up. Okay, and so if we look, two chiral centers are created, and so the two compounds that we get are mirror images. Okay, now let's look at the mechanism. Let's line everything up. Just going to rotate it around so it's easier to draw here, and I'm going to put the peroxyacid here. So that everything's lined up and ready to go. Driving force of this reaction is the breaking of the weak peroxide bond. We're then going to have to kick up this pi bond into an sp3 sigma bond to grab that hydrogen. And then when the bond between O and H break, we form the epoxide, and then the pi bond of the epoxide is forced to help fill the valence of the oxygen atom as the bond is breaking. And remember, all of this happens at once so that nothing is ever really without its full octet of electrons. And we drive this, like we said, by not only the breaking of that weak peroxide bond, we showed adding to the top in this example, but also by the formation of a stable small molecule carboxylic acid. But with ring compounds, it's a little easier to see the stereochemistry. Linear, I just want to point out that linear matters as well. And what I would recommend is not moving anything relative to the double bond. And let's just add to the top, keep all the carbons and atoms in place. And then add to the bottom. And so what that means is we're forcing up the two groups on either side, either here or here, here or here, if we're looking at it from directly on top. And so mentally the exercise is, can we visualize with in our heads or with a model kit what this does for the stereochemistry? And if we can, then we don't have to worry about the model kit, okay? But if we can't, we have to use the model kit. And so how does this end up looking as far as stereochemistry goes? Well, we can't have these structures because they're not technically proper perspective diagrams. So let's put the O in the plane. And again, we're just going to do both of these separately here. And so the way I've drawn it, that would put the methyl back, the hydrogen to the front, and here the methyl's coming forward. So a proper skeletal perspective diagram would look like this. Okay, with hydrogen's complement to the methyls. And then with the other, we end up getting the opposite, the enantiomer. And again, if we can see that manipulation, where I basically rotated this up to where it's in the plane, then we're in good shape. Otherwise, we have to, we're going to have to build a model for this. Okay, and if we name these, you will see that they are indeed enantiomers and have non-superimposable mirror images. But if we get the cis alkene, we do the same exercise. Keep everything lined up. Visualizing where everything has to go again. Knowing that if we're looking directly down, we've pushed everything up at us or away for the top addition. And let's redraw these again. And we see that with the cis, we get two mirror images that are superimposable. And they are meso. So in the final answer, what do we need? We only need show one of the two. Okay. And so we'll just say, what about this one? We'll show this one. They're the same compound because of the meso plane of symmetry in the middle of the compound. Everything reflects onto itself. And so even though it has two chiral centers, it is an achiral molecule.